I've recently been reading through the entire court transcript of the famous Dover trial, which was a court case arguing the scientific status of intelligent design. Numerous times during this trial, different people have essentially claimed that science cannot test the supernatural, that the supernatural is outside the realm of scientific method, so therefore science can have no say in the matter. Expert witness for the trial, Dr. Barbara Forrest, said, "Science by its nature and on the basis of its successful practice cannot address questions of the supernatural." The judge presiding over the case, who ruled against intelligent design as science, wrote, "Intelligent design violates the centuries-old ground rules of science by invoking and permitting supernatural causation." But why can't science test the supernatural? Judge Jones also cited this quote in his trial decision, "Anything that can be observed or measured is amenable to scientific investigation. Explanations that cannot be based on empirical evidence are not a part of science." Currently, medical science does not have the ability to regenerate limbs in humans. If you, in a controlled environment, observe 50 limbs growing back from stumps instantly after prayer, then the evidence likely points to a supernatural explanation. As the quote says, anything that can be observed or measured. If there is a being or force that can occasionally disrupt the laws of nature, why can we not detect it? Astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson had this to say on the subject of dark matter and dark energy.
In science, in astrophysics in particular, in all sciences, you have the capacity to measure something, even if you don't know what it is. You can make all manner of measurements and not know what's causing it. So dark energy.
Okay, that's what we say.
Is not light. It is not anything we've ever known about. Is that not anything we've ever otherwise measured? It remains a mystery, and so it defies all efforts of our spectroscopes and our spectrographs.
But we know that it's there.
Because we see its effects on the universe. Oh, yeah.
So we can't see dark energy, but we know its effects on the universe because...
We see its effects on other things.
That's
correct.
If, for instance, Christians claim that God heals people instantly after prayer, then isn't that a claim that can be tested? Can we not measure those results even if we don't know what's causing it? If a person can truly levitate and defy gravity, can that also not be tested? The James Randi $1 million paranormal challenge is based on this. The website states, "We offer a $1 million prize to anyone who can show, under proper observing conditions, evidence of any paranormal, supernatural, or occult power or event." Many creationists are in favor of redefining science to include supernatural explanations, which has alarmed much of the scientific community. Commenting on the Dover trial, Alan Leshner, the executive publisher of the journal Science, said, "Intelligent design is trying to drag science into the supernatural and redefine what science is and isn't." I can understand why scientists do not want their peers claiming God did it every time they make a discovery. They don't want scientific progress going backwards into superstition. They don't want scientists who don't investigate anything because they think it's God and that's final. But scientific claims must be backed up by empirical evidence. Why does there seem to be this notion that if we accept supernatural claims in science, then we are also to accept those claims without supporting evidence? If scientists are going to appeal to intelligent design, their claim will need to be peer-reviewed and accepted by the scientific community. As shown in the Dover trial, intelligent design proponents have failed to provide sufficient evidence, which is why their opponents won the court case. So what do you think? Can science test the supernatural? Should science be redefined to include supernatural explanations? Thanks for watching.